grab your hammers and switch from elemental, cause enhancement is back, baby dolls. And boy, does it hit like a mother lover. If you want to get a quick and efficient guide on what to pick, how to smash your buttons in dungeons and raids, then you came to the right place for the talents, covenants, conduits, legendaries, rotations, and oh, so much more. So sit on tight, relax, cause season 1 is open and we are kicking it with style. It's easier to raid and do dungeons and even play enhancement properly with specific add-ons. We use our own little made-up UI with the add-ons we think are necessary and update all of them through CurseForge, which are sponsoring this video. The app itself is very simple to use, no extra bloat, straightforward options, and so far the quickest way I had to get everything set up nice and easy. Check below the video for links to CurseForge and our add-ons video. Thank you, CurseForge, for sponsoring this video and making your app simple for a dumbass like me. Yo, you didn't have to write this shit! A quick disclaimer for the rest of the video. This is the beginning of the season and we are just establishing what works best for enhancement. Things will definitely change, more because Blizzard will nerf and buff stuff as they always do. Stay up to date with the video in our comment section where we will post changes, but also on our Discord and the Earth Shrine community as well. Talents, please, goddamn talents, man, come on! For raiding and dungeons, so essentially single and multi-target, go with forceful wins on the first row. This is essentially the biggest damage gain here for any type of encounter. It's Wind Fury damage on top of Wind Fury damage, and although this talent works pretty well on its own, with no legendaries, once you do get the one we will recommend later on in this video, this will probably be the only option you have here. Other than that, it's a passive that deals more damage, nothing to actually manage. Lashing Flames sims very closely to Forceful Winds, even without the synergy of its legendary, and in single target it has the potential to outscale its counterpart. For me, it has around 100 DPS loss if I pick it with the legendary that synergizes with Forceful Winds, so if you want to change in playstyle and you want to just mash one target at a time, Lashing Flames can be a thing and can switch it up, versatility, you know, all of that stuff. Second row, take Storm Flurry, again for both types of content. Most of the talents will be the same for the moment, unless Blizz takes a look at other enhancement builds. Storm Flurry essentially makes Storm Strike hits proc other Storm Strike hits that can also proc other Storm Strike hits. These can all cleave with Crash Lightning, which is pretty crazy, but also work nice in single target, mathematically anyway. Moving down, we come to the utility tiers, which are always subjective. We recommend Spirit Wolf. You don't really get much out of Earth Shield, and Static Charge is really not needed in M+, with all the CC everyone has. The level 35 row is the game changer though. For single targets, take Elemental Assault. This makes Storm Strike generate a Maelstrom weapon and deal more damage. The Maelstrom weapon generation does not apply to Storm Flurry procs, not sure about the damage though, but initial hits count and the resource generation is what diminishes downtime, which is a problem for single target more so than AoE. And I do say single target cause raids are mostly single target, but there are plenty of fights where going an AoE route is better, and going AoE is always better than M+, mostly cause you can't change talents anyway. For that, Hailstorm is the go-to and one of the coolest additions to enhancement. The rotation changes a bit and your mindset and approach will change a lot. Frost Shock will become a mandatory part of your rotation, replacing Flame Shock almost entirely, and managing Hailstorm stacks and Maelstrom weapon charges will be crucial. At certain points, you might not have enough Maelstrom weapon charges to keep Frost Shock on cooldown, while other times, it can feel like you need to overcap Hailstorm charges. Note that we color code these to make it easier if you are starting off, but that doesn't mean you cannot take Hailstorm on fights like Kael'thas. Next up, yet another utility row due to the lack of mobility. Feral Lunge is what I recommend you take. It helps with mechanics, especially when starting out. If your guild has set strategies or your group is pretty set on movement, other options can be of use for your survivability. On the 45 tier, nothing changed, sadly. Sundering still outshines all of these both in single target and AoE. nothing to explain here. Sundering is a big smash on the ground with a narrow area of effect, so positioning is very key. Also, it knocks back, knocks down, something would knock. It's also an extra button that helps with your rotation and downtime. Lastly, we come to the row with the most options to pick from. Right now, the king of single target by a very small margin is Ascendant. In terms of raw damage, this gives more single target than the rest. The most important aspect of this is the duration of the fight, because you will be using it on cooldown, so you essentially have Ascendant at minute 0, minute 2, and minute 4, and so on. If the fights last long enough for your Ascendant to drop and then, let's say, the boss dies, then this will be the best option here. Alternatively, Earthen Spike is a very, very close contender in pure single target. It adds again an extra button that can help with downtime and can even be something you can manage to fit in as much nature damage in its window as possible. Elemental Spirits is overall good for all options, but probably in dungeons more than anything. The cooldown being shorter fits the damage profile better, since dungeons want as many cooldowns as possible, even if the damage per individual use is smaller. Overall, the difference between all of them is not tremendous where you would lose out, and it comes down to what your objective is. Raid bosses will always prefer big burst windows in their vulnerable phases, or their downtime phase, or, you know, stuff like that, while dungeons want consistent damage all the time for overall faster speed clear, although sometimes burst is good there as well. And this is not always the case, mind you. Freedom is good, but freedom can be confusing, man. Stats have changed a lot in Shadowlands. First of all, you received a large stat squish, and secondary stats now have diminishing returns at higher percentages, I think starting with 35%. That means that stacking one stack in favor of others too much will not give you the most amount of DPS. Agility is the best stat at the moment, hence eye level will be the deciding factor when getting a new piece of gear. After that, haste is the next best thing. Haste not only reduces your global cooldown, but also reduces the actual cooldown of your rotational abilities, which pretty much all of them have a certain cooldown attached to themselves, making haste the primary stat of smoothing out your rotation and also a DPS increase as a consequence. After haste, you have crit and versatility fairly close to each other. Mastery becomes better and better the bigger the AoE fights will be, and all of these are not set in stone. If you really care about min-maxing and getting the most out of your character, simming yourself is the best way to find out what to equip, and we recommend raidbots.com to do so. The website is pretty straightforward and gives you a lot of options to choose from depending on what aspect of your character you are interested in optimizing. This time around, there are a lot more enchants that you can use and some that are very specific. We will go with overall the best choices for all content, but keep in mind that pure single target will prefer other options for very, very small DPS gains. Your weapons will have Celestial Guidance on the main hand and Lightless Force on the offhand. Celestial Guidance is the default one, and Lightless Force is better for more than one target, which is pretty much the majority of the content. The chest will have Eternal Stats. This is purely for throughput, nothing special here. While the boots get Eternal Agility, pretty straightforward. The gems will be the Haste options, aka the Quick Jewel Cluster, and the same goes for the Ring Enchants, which are now called Tenet of Haste. These will probably remain the same for most of the season, but depending on your stat weights, these can all change. Following the stat priority, Agility is King, aka the Potion of Spectral Agility will be your main choice, with the Flask being the Flask of Power. The Flask is the same for all classes now, since it gives main stat depending on what spec you are playing. You don't need to be worried with oils though, because weapon imbues will override them. Yes, you have joined the DK club, where the consumable layer of player power does not apply to your spec like everyone else. Enhancement does not need more damage. Don't be salty or projecting. Last but not least, the food. This will be ideally Feast of Gluttonous Hedonism, because agility is still king, no matter what. But the Tenebrous Crown Roast Aspic will probably be what you will be using most of the time. Here we go! Alright, Covenants are close-ish to each other, and chances are they will be one of the most touched and balanced systems of the expansion throughout the following months. Right now, Venthyr seems to be the best with Chain Harvest in AoE and very good for single target as well. Not only does it perform well, it also feels good to use since Maelstrom Weapon works on it, making it instant and deal more damage and healing. It's also easier to start since Nadia is the best Soulbind to go for and you want to pick Thrill Seeker and work your way towards Dauntless Duelist. This way you will have one Potency Conduit, which right now is Unruly Winds, but will probably change to Focused Lightning later on, since the latter is starting to seem better and better the more you gain level and the higher of a rank it is. So far, this seems to be the best build, but again, there's the disclaimer we talked about earlier. In terms of gear, we can start talking about trinkets. The two best performing trinkets, at least from a simulated perspective, are Dreadfire Vessel, which drops from Sire Denathrius, and Inscrutable Quantum Device, or how we like to call it, the trinket. Oh, we kid the bugs of Shadowlands. This one is found in the other side, the dungeon. These are pretty straightforward to get, but you can always sit with a stat proc trinket any day, so that's good for you. Now for the legendary. There are two we want to mention in their current state, and if Blizz will buff or nerf anything, we'll post it in the pinned comment below the video. Witch Doctor's Wolf Bones is by far the best simming single target option, but only single target. When you get Maelstrom Weapon charges, you reduce the cooldown of Feral Spirits by 2 seconds per charge, plus you have a 3% extra chance to generate said charge. The reason this is single target is because wolves only attack one target. Sure, they generate Maelstrom Weapon stacks, but that doesn't translate into enough AoE damage where this would be better than our next one in AoE, which is Doomwind. This is currently the best overall. Might do slightly less damage than Wolf Bones in single target, but destroys AoE scenarios. And because of this, Doomwind is what we recommend you pick. Even though, personally, I will have both and eventually all of the Legos for each situation in which we can change them. Doomwind essentially transforms your Wind Fury totem into a 1-minute cooldown of intense Wind Fury procs. This is the legendary I referred to earlier when I said the Forceful Winds talent works really well with it, because of the obvious Wind Fury synergy you get. I would love to see some of the other options get some love, maybe the Lava Lash and Flame Shock legendary so that we can play the other build and melt single targets, maybe even the AoE with Fire Nova talent. All sorts of options that are not that great at the moment. Until then, stick to this one. Assuming you are running the build we suggested, you will start with Flame Shock as you close in on the boss. Put down Wind Fury Totem, followed by Storm Strike and Feral Spirits. Then pop Ascendant and Wind Strike immediately, followed by the normal rotation. If you have taken Earthen Spike, then start with Flame Shock and then go Earthen into Wind Fury Totem, Storm Strike and Feral Spirits. If you don't use the Doomwind's legendary, simply start with the Wind Fury Totem before the pull, keeping the rest the same. With a single target build, Wind Fury Totem is number one to make sure it's active. Flame Shock next on your current target, Pearl Spirits and Ascendant on cooldown, Wind Strike on cooldown as well, Chain Harvest or Lightning Bolt if at 8 Maelstrom stacks or more, Storm Strike next, followed by Lava Lash in terms of priority, Crash Lightning further down the list, Refresh Flame Shock in its pandemic window, aka 5 seconds or less remaining, Frost Shock after, Sundering further down, Lightning Bolt if at 5 stacks of Maelstrom Weapon, and Refresh Wind Fury or any other totem if nothing else is available. This is a priority list, dear viewer. Even if I'm wasting resources in this section, this is purely to show you which ability is more important to cast versus the others. Note that if you are running the AoE build but are fighting on a dungeon boss, the priority is the same with the added effect that a full stacked Hailstorm Frost Shock is casted with a higher priority than 8 stacks Lightning Bolt and less than the Wind Strike Ascendant. For AoE, Wind Fury Totem is still numero uno on the priority list. Frost Shock with Hailstorm stacks next. Sundering third on the list, assuming you can hit multiple targets with its AoE. Feral Spirits after that for the Maelstrom Weapon charges. Chain Lightning to consume said charges. Crash Lightning next to activate your splash for Stormstrike and Lava Lash, which follow it in priority this exact same way. The difficulty and complexity of enhancement starts to shine once you try to optimize all of these resources, charges, stacks, buffs, and procs. It's probably the spec in the game with the most amount of stuff to manage, and you can get punished for fucking up. So don't beat yourself up if you don't get it right away. After weeks of playing, I am still nowhere near where I want to be, but the progress is visible, and damn does it feel good to start nailing this rotation, probably more than anything else. More than this, I recommend you check the Earth Shrine Discord, where the top enhanced boys and gals are rocking it hard with a lot of knowledge that can help you out and a lot of up-to-date information. Word Up wrote the Wowhead and Icy Veins guides for enhance with more details than we can include in the video. And shout out to the man for being one of the top enhanced in the world and always being a solid contributor to the community. Thanks also to Earth Shrine for compiling the best enhanced information on their Discord channel. Check them out. And of course, the patrons always get our appreciation for their support. Guys, thank you so much. This means a lot to us. And if you, dear viewer, are interested in supporting us a little bit more, obviously it's not required, but highly appreciated. Check the Patreon link down below. We have a lot of other links that you might be interested in. And thank you for watching the video. Hope you found it useful, and we'll see you next time. I've been loving it then, I still love it now. Still, I play WoW. Still, I play WoW. Getting better every day, let me show you how. Cause still, I play WoW. Still, I play WoW. It's getting harder to stay, but at the end of the day, it's a guilty pleasure, so just log in and play. Whether it's classic or retail, I'ma do a slash bow. Still, I play WoW.